Welcome to CoTech. In this tutorial, we will walk you through the core functionalities of iTAK, the iOS version of the Team Awareness Kit. If you have not performed the initial setup of iTAK, including connecting to the CoTech server, click the banner in the top right or navigate to cotech.gov and search for the iTAK Getting Started tutorial. When you open the iTAK app, you see a base map with a variety of icons that show your location and the locations of other first responders. Your location is shown as a colored dot with a white border. Other TAK app users are shown as multicolored dots with a black border. The color of the dot is controlled by the user's team color. CoTAK uses a standard to indicate what type of first responder a dot color corresponds to. Refer to the CoTAK guidance on this standard. Dots show the last reported GPS location of other first responders, which ranges from near real-time up to approximately 10 minutes old. A dot with an X through it indicates that a user is still running the TAK app, but has lost GPS reception. These dots with X's indicate the last known location of the responder, but may be several minutes old, and should be treated with caution as the responder may have moved in the meantime. Any dot, including your own, can be tapped on to receive more information on the item, or access the tools. When tapping on your own dot, iTAK will display the nearest address to your location, your GPS coordinates, speed, if applicable, call sign, role, and elevation. You will also be prompted with a gear wheel, which is a shortcut to the user preferences page. Here, you can change your call sign and team color. When tapping on another first responder's dot, you will see their call sign, nearest address, GPS coordinates, speed, range or distance from you, bearing from you to them, and elevation. Below these details, you will see three options. Start track will keep the map centered on that marker. Call will allow you to call this user's phone number, and text will allow you to message this user. While at first, this doesn't seem that useful, in a mutual aid scenario, you can message directly to individuals you've never met before. When tapping on a vehicle or aircraft dot, you will again receive details on location and bearing. You may also start a track. However, rather than calling and messaging, you have the options to manually share a point or edit it. Points that are automatically generated by CoTAK are likely pointless to edit since their information will revert the next time the point's location is updated. The Bloodhound tool appears when tapping on any marker and is useful when you need to navigate to a map marker, whether stationary or mobile. Tap the marker and the small blue Bloodhound icon. A straight line from your location to the marker will appear, along with the details of the compass bearing from you to the marker and straight line distance in the top bar. The system will calculate the estimated time of arrival to the marker based on the current speeds and directions of the markers. But note, this feature does not account for road traffic or topography. To quit this feature, tap Dismiss. To locate yourself, tap on the arrow in the upper right corner, and the map will center on your current location. Many users find it helpful to lock the map on yourself while navigating or driving. Simply tap again on the arrow to lock the map to your location. A third tap will change the orientation of the map to be locked to the current compass heading of your device. Tap again on the arrow to unlock the map and reorient the map so north is up. Dropping points or markers in iTAK is as simple as a long press on the screen. Once the marker has been dropped, a menu appears allowing you to change the coordinate and choose the marker type by tapping the marker in the title bar. When finished, swipe down to remove the menu. To share, tap the marker and select Share. Share with contacts and tap the individuals with which you'd like to share, or share with all. It is a similar process to delete a marker. Tap on it, click Edit, and remove. The toolbar menu is found across the bottom of the screen in iTAK. If it is not on your screen, short tap on the map and it will appear. We will now review the most commonly used tools in iTAK from left to right on the toolbar. Swipe left or right on the toolbar to view additional tools. The Go To tool is useful when you need to zoom to an area but don't need to place a marker. You may search either by coordinate or address. The chat tool allows you to message other TAC app users. By default, you will see a general chat available, which will allow you to message all other TAC users who are online. You may message individuals or create a custom group by tapping on the plus button and selecting the appropriate option. The Contacts tool shows a list of other TAC app users who are online and on your channels. Tapping on a contact will zoom the map to that user's location. The Drawing tool allows you to create either a circle or a custom shape. To create a circle, first click on the map to designate the center of the circle. Then, tap again to assign the radius of the circle. To create a custom shape, select the pentagon. From here, begin tapping points on the map to create the shape you desire. You may leave your drawing as a line by pressing the X in the details box, or you can create a full shape by closing the perimeter. From here, you can press the white dot to share, edit, or delete the shape that you've created. The Layers tool is where you can add, delete, or toggle layers on and off. This will likely be items specific to your needs and includes shapes, lines, trails, or even imported maps. Toggle it with the green dot and access item details by tapping on the eye. You may edit its name, share, export, delete, and even airdrop that item. Finally, to the far right is the TAC Channels tool, which allows you to turn on and off channels on the Kotak server. Turning a channel on shares your location with all other users on that same channel and enables you to interact with the users. Turning a channel off removes your location and presence from that channel. This concludes the Getting Started tutorial for iTAK, powered by the Colorado Department of Public Safety and the Center of Excellence for Advanced Technology Aerial Firefighting. To learn more, visit us at kotak.gov.